My name is Paul Camping. I have devoted my life to my inventions. My dream has been to develop the next generation of cars. I wanted to make a car, but I wanted it to be more than just a vehicle for transporting people. I wanted it to have a mind and a soul. But my experiments were expensive and unconventional, so no one would invest in me. Regardless, I needed money. Before my big breakthrough, I met Richard Schietergeist, a rich and powerful man. He agreed to finance my operations. With his money backing my work, I was able to make significant enhancements to several cars. Now all I have to do is iron out a few more wrinkles, and the cars will actually be alive. I experimented on a number of cars throughout the city. I don't think anyone will notice the changes. However... Cheatergeist has twisted everything I created. He wants to use my technology to create mechanisms that obey only him. I must stop this madman, and the only way to do it is to use my cars. I hope my calculations are correct.
Who are you? It's been a long time since someone has been through here. My car is shattered. How could anyone be so barbaric? Please place the mirror where it belongs. Thank you for your help. Thanks to Mr. Camping's experiments, I'm immortal. The only problem is, My soul is forever attached to this car. Thank you. I could never repay you for this favor. However, please take my locket. You will find it to be useful.
Good afternoon, young lady. I'm pleased to meet you. And you should be pleased to meet me. I am one of the most experienced detectives in this city. I've seen a lot of fascinating things during my many years as an investigator. But the truth is, I'm rather tired of it all. However, I am curious about one thing. Have you ever seen a detective without a pipe? You know, you don't even need to say why you're here. I already know. Thank you. damn tie. It won't let me rest in peace. It's choking me. I can't loosen it. Well, don't just stand there staring at me. Help me. Thanks. I'm in your debt, so please take this.